I invite you all to EPG Pathshala. Myself, Professor Sampath Kumar Swain, teaching at Department of Tourism Management as a professor in Indira Gandhi National Tribal University, Amarkantak. Today, we will be discussing about a topic that is UNWTO's Global Code of Ethics for Tourism. After completing this module, students should be able to comprehend UNWTO's Global Code of Ethics, understand the aims and objectives of Global Code of Ethics of Tourism, know reasons behind implementation of GCET. Introduction. The history of ethics in tourism is a recent phenomena. It was first proposed in the International Association of Scientific Experts in Tourism Congress in the year 1992. That held in Paris. It proposed the conception of a commission that deals with ethical problems in tourism. And in the year 1992, Rio Yard Summit, Agenda 21, it called upon institutions to adopt codes of ethics in their organizational practices. The ethics is very root cause of good and bad associations between host and guest. The ethics of tourism issues tied to human rights, environmental justice, equity and virtue of ethics. It encourages greater transparency in work that pays close attention to the ethical issue in gathering data and conducting research. The ethics builds an attitude of tolerance and respect toward the moral beliefs and philosophical issues. It builds cooperation between diversity of people in their religious belief. It is the foundations of responsible and sustainable tourism as viewed by UNWTO Global Code of Ethics for Tourism. In the year 2001, UNWTO has established Global Code of Ethics that focuses on universal standards of addressing different aspects and traits such as cross-cultural tolerance, promotion of human rights, environmental and developmental sustainability, accessibility, economic growth, reduction of poverty and self-education. However, ethical standards are purely voluntary, though it is not a legal binding document. There is a provision for a voluntary implementation of Global Code of Ethics. For tourism, the different stakeholders, institution and organization may refer on a voluntary basis regarding the matter concerning the application and implementation of the Code of Ethics. The role of the World Committee on Tourism Ethics, WCTE, holds preeminence in the formulations and implementation of legal framework of tourism internationally. The WCTE is a subsidiary organ that reports directly to the General Assembly of UNWTO. It has been assigned with tasks such as promotion and dissemination of code of ethics and evaluation and monitoring the implementation of the ethics. The Global Code of Ethics for Tourism, GCET, was adopted on October 1, 1999 in the meeting of General Assembly of United Nations World Organization in Santiago, Chile. This contains set of principles for the key players of the tourism industry, including the governments, the travel industry, communities and tourists alike. It aims at minimizing the negative impacts on environment, society and culture and maximizing economic benefits across the world. At the meeting, the UNWTO General Assembly recommended states, members or non-members of UNWTO, without being obliged to do so, to accept expressively the principles embodied in the Global Code of Ethics for Tourism and to use them as a basis when establishing their national laws and regulations and to inform accordingly the World Committee on Tourism Ethics. Global Code of Ethics for Tourism is a guidebook for principles for all stakeholders, entrepreneurs, workers, local communities, etc. worldwide. The idea of this global code was conceived in 1997 when a committee was formed during the UNWTO General Assembly meeting in Istanbul. The process of preparation involved a wide range of discussion and consultation with all stakeholders of tourism industry for the benefit and development of tourism industry worldwide. More than 70 member states and other entities sent their written comments on the concept of quote. The UNWTO meeting held in Santiago, Chile in October 1999 and finalized 10 principles of global code of conduct for tourism that was subsequently approved by UNWTO General Assembly in UNWTO Resolution A/REA/406X3I. Then in the year 2001, a draft resolution on global code of ethics for tourism was adopted by the United Nations Economic and Social Council. This global code of ethics for tourism got final official recognition by United Nations General Assembly on 21st of December 2001 through UN Resolution A/REA/56/212. As per the directions of the United Nations, the World Tourism Organization has since then been promoting this code of ethics for implementation by member countries worldwide. As not a legally binding document, all provisions in the document is voluntary, to which stakeholders may choose to implement for the long-term benefit of the industry. In the process of implementation of this global code of ethics, the World Committee on Tourism Ethics (WCTE) has gained its prominence as an autonomous and impartial body of UNWTO. Aims. The basic objectives of the Global Code of Ethics for Tourism are to establish a synthesis of the documents, quotes and declarations out of the available records or by comparing the aspirations of stakeholders published over the years. Complement the quotes, documents and declarations with the new considerations which would reflect the growth and development of the society. Serve as a term of reference for the stakeholders in the tourism industry. World Committee on Tourism Ethics (WCTE) established in the year 2004, World Committee on Tourism Ethics is an independent and impartial body of UNWTO. It directly reports to the General Assembly of UNWTO. As a subsidiary organ, the members of the World Committee on Tourism Ethics are selected on their personal capacities rather than as official or representatives of governments of member countries. The committee is responsible for interpreting, applying and evaluating the provisions of the Global Code of Ethics for tourism in promotion of sustainable and responsible tourism. The mandate of this committee rests with task of promotion and dissemination of code of ethics, evaluation and monitoring the implementation of the ethics, Global Code for Ethics for Tourism, GCET. Global Code of Ethics for Tourism contains 10 articles in which there are 9 principles and the 10th article is the summary of all other focused on the implementation part. These articles are further divided into subsections with laws and regulations and recommendations mentioned for various stakeholders of tourism. The 10 articles are mentioned below. Tourism's contribution to mutual understanding and respect between peoples, societies, tourism as a vehicle for individual and collective fulfillment, tourism as a factor of sustainable development, tourism a user of the cultural heritage of mankind and a contributor to its enhancement, tourism a beneficial activity for host countries and communities, obligations of stakeholders in tourism development, a right to tourism, liberty to tourist movements, rights of the workers and entrepreneurs in the tourism industry, implementation of the principles of the Global Code of Ethics and for tourism. Article 1, contribution of tourism to mutual understanding and respect between peoples and society. The article observes tourism sector is well known for developing goodwill and harmony among regions and countries. people's motives to travel to a place can be judged over the selection of place or a destination. While traveling, tourists or visitors come across different societies and traditions. They experience different culture and practices. Therefore, they must maintain the dignity of other culture and must have a sense of respect for them. The tradition and culture of minorities and indigenous people must be observed. Tourist activities must be done in sync with the traditions and culture of the host community. On the other hand, the host community must have respect for the tourist and they must supply them with all important information. They must not misguide or misbehave with them. The host community must provide a warm welcome and hospitality to the tourist. Government or the concerned authorities must ensure the safety and security of the tourist. They must provide protection from illegal activities such as communal raids, war, kidnapping, murder, rape, snatching of goods, theft, etc. Nonetheless, the natural and cultural heritage must be preserved and conservation and preservation laws must be implemented. No criminal act should be allowed. Misconduct with tourists must not be allowed. However, tourists must keep themselves away from any criminal activity. They must not indulge in any offensive act like smuggling, trafficking of valuable species, etc. Tourists must collect enough of information of rules and regulations, travel formalities and health information before the departure from their respective countries of residence. Article 2. Tourism as a vehicle for individual and collective fulfillment. In any tourist destination, whatever tourist activities take place, that must be linked with rest and relaxation. It should provide learning about different culture of different people or society and of different region. There should not be any discrimination between men and women in any form. Equality must be maintained. Cooperation of all states is mandatory in promoting human rights and it should be meant for all classes of people without any discrimination. Exploitation in any form must not be accepted. And in any case, any such listing, states should deal with it, educating people about touristic activities and benefits of tourism, like social and cultural benefits. Economic benefits is also very necessary. On the other hand, tourists must be told about the risk. Article 3. Tourism as a factor of sustainable development. Article 3 enshrines about development that one thing always strikes our mind, whether it is sustainable or not. Sustainability must be maintained in all forms, be it environment or cultural or social or economic. Sustainability. Tourism development must safeguard natural environments for present as well as future growth. Ecotourism should be promoted and natural heritage preservation should be given top priority. Priority should also be given to conserve energy at all levels such as local, regional and national level. Destination carrying capacity should be maintained while conducting any tour or tourist activity. The infrastructural development in the name of tourism activities must be limited in order to protect natural heritage. Article 4. Tourism as a user of the cultural heritage of mankind and its contributor to its enhancement. Article 4 briefs the following ethics in its subsections. The local community plays a greater role in protecting and enhancing cultural heritage. Tourism uses the cultural heritage of the local community as a product. Thus, the local communities should have rights and obligations on the cultural heritage. They should protect the local culture, maintain its authenticity, and pass this on to the future generation. Government must make policies and activities for protection, and they should also ensure that tourism should not affect any of the cultural heritage, such as historical monuments or other structures. Revenue obtained from the visits to the heritage places should be utilized for the development and conservation of the heritage. Article 5. Tourism as a beneficial activity for host countries and communities. Article 5 comprehends the benefits of tourism to the host countries and communicates. Tourism is a beneficial activity that brings prosperity in the society and local communities. Right from creation of jobs to implementation of policies, it plays a significant role in raising standard of living, quality of life, meeting the needs of the host communities and countries. Therefore, the participation of the host community in providing activities and services to the tourist is mandatory for economic, cultural and social benefits. While framing policies, government or the concerned authorities must consider the local people and their social and economic growth. Economic growth is found less in coastal and hill areas, so that such regions must be given special attention because such places lag behind in development than the other accessible places. On regular interval studies on impact should be done by the authorities or its professionals, keeping in view the objectives. Suitable corrections and change in the policies need to be affected if negative impacts are noticed in the due course of development. Article 6. Obligations of stakeholders in tourism development. This article includes obligations of stakeholders to be followed in tourism industry. Stakeholders pay a great contribution to the tourism industry as they provide good ambience for tourists, quality of experience, and supply tourists with a valuable destination. Information stakeholders in tourism thus must provide accurate and genuine information about activities and services about a destination. The information related to nature, price, quality must be maintained clearly in the documents given to the tourists at the time of booking. Such information should not be exaggerated so that their committed services are not different from the services being offered. In case of service deficiency, providers should compensate the tourists against such deficiency in services. The services so offered must be in accordance with the national regulations. At the same time, they should show concern in cooperation with public authorities for safety and security, protection and food safety, etc. Stakeholders must update tourists with the travel regulations and existence of insurance and assistance, as tourists may face any adverse situation related to travel formalities while traveling abroad. It is government's duty to inform their nationals of any probable difficult situation faced by the tourist. Travel advisors should discuss regarding this with the host countries and concerned people beforehand. Media plays an important role in it, so that they should provide accurate, reliable, balanced and genuine information without disrespecting the rules and regulations of the host countries. Article 7, right to tourism. Every human being has got some fundamental rights, and right to tourism discussed as a fundamental right in the 7th article of the Global Code, tourism should be open to all inhabitants of the world without any discrimination for the proper utilization of the leisure, be it disabled people or any other. Facilities must be provided to disabled. At the same time, they should be encouraged to travel. For this, they ought to have the right to rest and leisure, including limitation in working hours and periodic holidays, so that there could be more and more participation of tourists in various tourism activities. Social tourism should be enhanced by providing facilities for travel and leisure activities. Public authority support is required in this way. Article 8, liberty of tourist movements. The subsection of Article 8 also relates to free movement of tourists. The growth of tourism industry cannot be imagined without tourist movement, so that there has to be freedom to move anywhere they wish, be it their own country or region or other countries. There should not be too much or formalities which may tangle them. Formalities related to the visa, entry, health, etc. must be simplified for convenience. There should be access to the places that tourists wish to visit and access to communication, stays, transits, legal and health services, and access to allowances of convertible currencies for tourists. There should not be any discrimination, and tourists should have the same rights as the citizens have in their particular country. Article 9, rights of the workers and entrepreneurs in tourism industry. In order to ensure a healthy work environment, the Global Code outlines the rights of the worker and in entrepreneurs in the tourism industry in the Article 9, like right to tourism and right to tourism movements. Workers and entrepreneurs have got some rights in the tourism industry. Every employee in the industry has a right to get initial training, which is provided by the firm. There should be job security for the seasonal workers, and they should be given social protection, and there should be interaction program for exchanging experience between executives and workers from different regions and different countries. Such interactions contribute to the development of the industry. The entrepreneurs should involve themselves in social developments. Partnership among various organizations and building relations between enterprises help in sustainable development and growth. Article 10, implementation of the principles of Global Code of Ethics for Tourism. Article 10 is the summarization of all the other articles of the Code of Ethics. The stakeholders who implement the principles need to be propitiated. Stakeholders should show their intentions to refer the disputes concerning interpretation of Global Code of Ethics for Tourism. The article emphasizes public and private stakeholders to cooperate and complement each other in the implementation of Code of Ethics. All players in tourism should respect, apart from the guidelines of international law, the role of international tourism organizations such as the UNWTO and other non-governmental tourism organizations in all aspects of tourism activities. All stakeholders should approach the World Committee on Tourism Ethics as an impartial third party to resolve and disputes amicably. Summary: Global Code of Ethics for Tourism aims at minimizing the negative impacts on environment, society and culture, and maximizing economic benefits. The Secretary General and legal advisors first consulted with UNWTO's Business Council, Regional Commissions and Executive Council, and after the consultation, the draft document for Code of Ethics was prepared. Though it is not a legally binding document, a provision is made for a voluntary implementation of Global Code of Ethics for Tourism. Stakeholders may refer on a voluntary basis matter concerning the implementation and application of the Code of Ethics. The role of the World Committee on Tourism Ethics, WCT, thus holds primacy in the formulation of legal framework of tourism internationally. The WCT reports directly to the General Assembly of UNWTO as a subsidiary organ of it. It has been assigned with the task such as promotion and dissemination of Code of Ethics and evaluation and monitoring the implementation of the ethics. The GCET contains 10 articles in total. The first 9 principles are summarized in 10th article, and all these articles have got some subsections in which different laws, regulations and recommendations are mentioned for conduct of stakeholders in the tourism industry. The adoption of GCET shows the development of international law in tourism and holds importance for formulation of national legal framework of tourism worldwide. Apart from providing guidance for the stakeholders of tourism industry, the Global Code of Ethics for Tourism is not a binding on all the stakeholders. However, tourists, service providers, governments, and all other stakeholders, including communities, must respect the Global Code of Ethics. That will result in bringing tourism a vibrant and dynamic industry in the world that would bring many positive benefits to the global, to the globe, and to the many countries in the world. With this, I would like to conclude this presentation. Thank you.